The Mahdi. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that the Day of Judgment will not take place until Allah sends a man from my descent, from my progeny. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us about the Mahdi. And the word Mahdi in Arabic means the guided one. The guided one. His name is Muhammad. His father's name is Abdullah. His descent and lineage comes from where? From Fatima. Through her son Al-Hasan. From her husband Ali, her father Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes him. The Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, he says, أَجْلَ الْجَبْهَ. He has a broad, clear forehead. Here, not much hair at the front. Very broad and clear forehead. أَقْنَ الْأَنْف. Prominent nose, like high up a bit. Tiny and high up a bit. Describes him, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, he will spread this world justice and peace after it was filled up with injustice and oppression. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says something amazing about this character. You are talking about a very strong character, a very brave character, a very wise character, a very smart character. Al-Mahdi is a very wise, smart, religious, pious, brave, courageous character. You know all these characteristics of a good leader? It does not exist in him until the day and the night Allah decides or decrees upon him that he becomes the Mahdi. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in this amazing hadith, يُصْلِحُهُ اللَّهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ. Within one night, Allah will change his character from being maybe an average or weak character into a strong and a powerful character. One night. So if you look around, who do you see as the Mahdi? Who'll be the last one to be chosen? Yes? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, it's on that night that Allah decrees for him to be declared the Mahdi, is that night that Allah Azza wa Jalla changes his character. His character changes from being the average, simple, humble man into a leader, into braveness and courage, smart, wise. All this happens in one night. So he's not someone that he's prepared for it. Allah prepares him in one night. يُصْلِحُ اللَّهُ فِي لَيْلًا. When he comes, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that this world will be filled up with oppression and injustice. When he comes, he'll fill up this world with justice and peace. And not only that, but in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let the rain come down and the ground to produce its production. Even in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says how prosperous and fruitful his time will be. He'll have so much money, he'll give it out and he doesn't even count it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make his time a time of prosperity, a time of justice and peace. Even in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says the moment that he comes out, indication when he comes out, he comes out during a moment with three brothers, a children that are the children and the sons of a Khalifa. That's why the scholars say there could be Khilafah before the Mahdi. Three brothers belong to one father, Khalifa. After the death of their father, they'll fight over his kingdom. After the death of their father, they'll fight over the kingdom of their father. One will kill the other two. And they'll fight over treasure under the Kaaba. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, they'll fight over treasure under the Kaaba. At that moment, the family of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will be oppressed. And he is from the family of the Prophet Alayhi Salatu Wasallam, the Mahdi. In Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he describes, he will escape from Medina to Mecca. He will escape from Medina to Mecca from the oppression that the leader at that time will put upon the family of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam describes him as the refugee, that resorts to Allah azza wa jal in Mecca. A'idh al-bayt. Someone who escape from Medina to Mecca seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection. And it resorts to Allah. And where is he? He's in Mecca. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, people recognize him. And the scholars tell us who are these people that recognize him. The scholars, the righteous scholars with knowledge, they recognize this man looks like something about him. So what do? They force him to give him bay'ah. You are the Mahdi. There are some signs that Allah is putting in our hearts that you are the Mahdi. We want to give you pledge. Yukra, he will be compelled. He doesn't stand up and say, oh people, I am the Mahdi. The moment someone does that, know that he's a liar. Alhamdulillah. That's the first sign. He does not stand up and say, I am the Mahdi. He will be compelled, he will be forced to be given the bay'ah. He will refuse. In some ahadith says, he will refuse. And then he'll come back again, and then he'll be forced to be given the bay'ah. That's when he accepts, and that's where the scholars and the righteous people will surround him. Not everyone, the scholars and the righteous people will surround him. The second sign, which is amazing, a Muslim army will come and fight against the Mahdi. Not non-Muslims. A Muslim army with black banners and flags will come from the east to fight against the Mahdi. On their way from Medina to Mecca, Allah will collapse the ground under them and swallow them. That's the other sign. When the Mahdi is given bay'ah to, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam even tells us where he'll be given the bay'ah to, between Hajar al-Aswad and Maqam Ibrahim. Between Hajar al-Aswad and Maqam Ibrahim, that's where he'll be given the bay'ah. Then the news starts to spread that there is the Mahdi. So a Muslim army will come from the east with black flags, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says. When they are in the middle of the desert between Medina and Mecca, the ground will swallow them, will collapse and swallow them. That's another sign that he is the Mahdi. One day, Aisha says, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a sleepless night. He had a sleepless night, moving all night, waking up, going to sleep. So Aisha said, oh Messenger of Allah, I've never seen you have a sleepless night like this before. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, yes, I'm amazed. The people from my nation will mobilize an army to fight someone from my nation, from my progeny. I'm amazed that people from my nation will gather together and fight someone from my family, from Quraysh. Until they arrive in the middle of the desert will collapse and swallow them. So she said, oh Messenger of Allah, everyone? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, everyone. So she said, oh Messenger of Allah, all of them are bad. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, no. Some came out with the army intentionally to fight against the Mahdi. The other people of the hellfire. Others were not sure, they just followed. Allah will bring him back in the hereafter according to their intention. Others were forced to be in the army. Others were forced to be in the army. So Allah Azza wa Jalla will look at their intention. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, only few will stay alive, they will tell the rest about what happened. Then another Muslim army will come and fight with him. So the first Muslim army will come with black banners, fighting against the Mahdi. Allah will destroy them. Allah will make the ground in the middle of the desert to swallow them, collapse. Then after that, the news will be widespread. Everyone will be hearing about it. And everyone will confirm the signs. So another Muslim army will be mobilized and assembled around him, fighting for him under black banners. Ikhwani, wallahi, it's scary. It's scary. Which army are you going to be in if you live at that time?
It's scary. That's why the scholars taught us one thing. Don't wish you at that time. Don't say, oh, I'm not going to do anything until the Mahdi comes. Oh, this ummah, this ummah, that. You don't know when that time comes who you're going to be with. You don't know at that time when it comes who you're going to stand with. This is fitan, this is tests. These are the times of tests. These are the times of hardships. These are the times of afflictions. And the Muslims will be led by the Mahdi at that time. The Muslims will be led by the Mahdi at that time. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, the day of judgment will not take place until you see six things. The sixth one that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam mentions, he says there will be a peace treaty between the Muslims and the yellow people, or the yellow tribe. Who are the Europeans? The Romans. Together, the Muslims and the Europeans, they'll fight a common enemy. Muslims and the Europeans. And when you say Europeans, you refer to more as Christians. The Muslims and the Christians will have a peace treaty. And they'll fight a common enemy. Who's that common enemy? Allahu A'lam. Then, what happens? The Romans will break the treaty. So now you've got the Muslims and the Christians from the Europeans. There's a peace treaty between them. They'll fight a common enemy and they'll be victorious. They'll win the war. Then the Europeans or the Romans will break the treaty. Then in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, they will mobilize their army, the Europeans, and come and fight against the Muslims under 80 banners, every banner 12,000 soldiers under it. Total 960,000 soldiers. Look how precise the Prophet says. One Christian or crusader will carry the cross, and he says, because of that, we were victorious. So the Muslim says, no, because of Allah we were victorious. So they'll fight one another. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam even tells us the details of this war, how amazing this war is. And this is during the time of the Mahdi. A fight and a battle never seen ever before. That even if a bird will go above them, it will fall dead until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them victory. So when do they get victory? On the fourth day after many Muslims had died. Then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud interprets what he said, the day of judgment will not come until there is no inheritance to be divided and no booty or spoils to be happy about. He says, when the Muslims obtain victory on the fourth day, out of every 100 in one tribe, one will stay alive. Where do they fight one another? In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not only he tells us the country, but even the city and the town. In Dabiq, A'maq wa Dabiq, north of Syria, 45 kilometers from Aleppo, 15 kilometers close to the Turkish borders. He says, alayhi salatu wassalam, an army will come out of Medina. The Muslim army will come out of where? Medina. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, they are the best of people standing on the surface of this earth at that time. The army, the Muslim army, will come out of Medina to face and fight the Roman army. Where? In Dabiq. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, they are the best of people and horsemen standing on the surface of this earth that time. He says, alayhi salatu wassalam, when the Muslims and the Romans deploy their armies and they line up their armies and face one another, the Romans will call upon the Muslims and say to them, let our own kind, from our own people, from our own color and skin, take them out of your army so we could fight them. Indication that there will be a lot of Romans, Europeans who are Muslims, who are in the Muslim army. So the Romans will say, where's the people from our kind? We want to fight them. Those who left us and betrayed us, we want to fight them first. So the Muslims will reply back and say, No, but Allah. We'll never ever let go of our own brothers. They're our brothers. We don't look at them, Europeans or non-Europeans. They're our brothers, they're Muslims. By Allah, we'll never let go or betray our own brothers. So they'll fight one another. They will fight one another. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, a third of the Muslim army will be defeated. Not only that, in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Allah would not even accept their repentance when they see the large number of the Roman army and how big they are and how powerful they are and the number of their soldiers and their, you know, and the number of their armies. A third will get scared and apostate Islam. Allah does not even accept their repentance. The second third, in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, they will fight till death. They are the best of martyrs and shuhada. And the last third, the third third, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them victory on their hands. Allah will give victory on the last third that stays firm and strong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them victory against the Romans. How precise the details of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he says, have you heard of a city, half of it is on land and the other half is in the ocean? So they said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, the day of judgment would not take place until 70,000 people from the progeny and the tribe of Bani Ishaq, referring to Ishaq, the son of Ibrahim. And Bani Ishaq here are the Romans. Here, indication that there will be a large number of Europeans who will embrace Islam. And then they'll fight for Islam and the Muslims. And then they'll fight their own people to uphold Islam. Banu Ishaq. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he says, the day of judgment would not take place until 70,000 people from the children and the progeny of Ishaq, who are Europeans that became Muslims, they will go to Constantinople, that land that's half into the sea and half into or on land. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he says, when they arrive it, they will conquer it without any fighting, without even drawing the sword. Alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, thou will open it by the takbir and the tahleel. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. That's all they say. They do not take out any weapon. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he says, Allah will open that city on their hands by La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. He says, alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, the first time they will say, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, its part in the sea will fall. Its part, its construction on the sea will fall. Then the second time they will say, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, its part on land will fall. And then the third time they say, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, its gates and fortress will fall, so the Muslims will conquer it. While the Muslims are celebrating victory and dividing the booty amongst them, a caller will call and say, the Dajjal had arrived and he's attacking your people back in Sham. The Muslim army will decide to send 10 horsemen. The amazing part, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, by Allah, those 10, I know their names. I know the names of their fathers. I know the color of their horses. It's like Al-Nabi Sassam's got the full report. They are the best of horsemen standing on the surface of this earth at that time. They'll go and investigate. Is it true? Well, they've heard that the Dajjal had arrived and is attacking and aiming for their people. While the Muslims are prepared to pray Salat al-Fajr in Al-Quds. So who comes? Isa. Isa alayhi salam, the one that Allah promised that he'll return. What does the Mahdi do? Isa? Who am I to lead the praise when Isa is here? So the Amir, the leader of the Muslim army at that time, the Mahdi, who say to Isa, or Isa, you lead the praise. You lead the praise. You're a prophet. I'm just a normal human being. You're a prophet. There's no doubt you're better than me. So you know what Isa says? He says, no. You are leaders over each other. You are leaders over one another. And this salah, this iqama, was made for you as a respect and honor to this nation. The nation of who? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, no, you lead the prayer. The iqama was made for you, and you are leaders over one another as a respect and honor to this nation, the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amazing. How precise the details of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So the Mahdi will live. He will live and rule between 7 and 9 years, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam says. And then he'll die, and the Muslims will bury him, and they'll pray on him and bury him. And then the leadership of the Muslim Ummah will be in the hands of Isa alayhi salam. So his leadership and rulership is only short. It's short, only between 7 to 9 years, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says. Insha'Allah, next talk about the connection between Mahdi and Isa. Because now we start talking about the major signs of the Day of Judgment, which is the arrival of Isa and Dajjal comes before Isa, and so on, inshallah. Ask Allah to make us from amongst us. You listen in here, act upon what they listen here. Subhanakallahumma hamdaka, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.